James Robson from RM Capital is with me in the studio. James, afternoon, good to see you.
Thanks for having me along, Andrew.
James, you've recently raised £7.1 million. Talk me through the reasons for the raise and I suppose why now?
Okay, so we had our initial IPO in December. We raised £50 million, just over £50 million. And we've really been deploying that money since December. Really, we wanted to maintain momentum. We had committed all of that money that we had raised, and we wish to continue that deployment and some further deployment for projects and opportunities that we had identified. So we went to the market really to speak with existing shareholders and meet with new shareholders in order to look to raise a little bit more money.
I suppose what you said earlier to me, momentum, that's really the key issue for you, isn't it?
Momentum is the key because it takes time to engage with borrowers. We at RM Capital engage with borrowers. These projects typically relate to borrowers with relatively complex financing requirements. So it takes time to understand those requirements and also to do the due diligence and to document them. So on that basis, it's really important that whilst you have momentum and you have borrowers and you have people looking to engage with you, that you can continue those dialogues and you have capital to deploy.
Speaking of which, let's just remind people of the numbers. So since IPO, you've raised $57
million. Yes.
Committed, how much?
We've committed £54 million.
That's right.
And really, our objective there was to, as I mentioned, to maintain momentum, to raise a little bit of additional funding now. The strategy that we have, we're looking to roll out, will be to go to get a bank revolving credit facility next. Mm-hmm. We have within our documentation the ability to raise up to 20% of the fund, to leverage 20% of the fund in debt. So realistically, we'll be looking to raise about £10 million, which we'll announce probably over the next 1 to 2 months, a revolving credit facility with a bank. That will then take us really some additional money to deploy over the summer period, whereupon we'll look to do a larger, more significant raise in Q3, Q4 this year, which will really get our fund or get the company to the more significant sort of magic £100 million level, which is really what a lot of investors are looking for, both the existing investors within the fund who are looking to be part of a larger, more liquid structure, and also new investors that are waiting on the sidelines and just waiting for the fund to be slightly bigger before they commit.
Absolutely. I suppose that nearer term milestone, I suppose we're talking a matter of days, a week or so before you're going to be fully deployed with the funds that you've got.
Yeah.
That's quite an achievement.
I think so. And it's really when we went on the IPO roadshow at the back end of last year, we had a pathway that we'd mapped out for deployment. And really we have kept on that pathway in exactly the way that we described to investors at the time. So I think the feedback that we've received from investors from our recent roadshow with them has been that they're very pleased with the deployment. We've minimized the cash drag within the fund. We've deployed capital into investments that we identified at the outset back in 2016, and also some new opportunities that have come our way that have been pretty exciting as well.
Let's talk about some of those opportunities. Of course, it wasn't too long ago, I think earlier this month when I was speaking to Pietro Nichols,
He
was talking me through the investment in Glasgow.
Yeah.
But you've made a couple since then.
We have. We've done some energy transactions, which we're really pleased with because we did have energy as one of our larger sort of sector exposure limits when we started that we were identifying. And those opportunities have come through and we've deployed £4 million to a hydro transaction in Scotland where we're funding a land lease, which is secured on the underlying hydro power station itself as well. And we've funded 6 biofuel power stations, like mini power stations, if you like, as well around the country, which is, I believe, another £5 million as well. So there's £9 million there towards energy. And finally, we've also funded the sort of last mile debt funding for quite a large boutique hotel in central London. So the sponsor has put in a lot of equity funding to date, and really we're funding that last piece of the development, which we're really excited about.
That's quite interesting. Your borrowers certainly do come from a varied range of sectors, don't they?
Yes, they do. And I think, you know, we at RM Capital, you know, we source and originate all of our own opportunities. We don't use any platforms, and that means that we do have to go out and find some interesting investments for the company.
So from an investor's perspective, I suppose that big target you're looking to hit this year is hitting that £100 million fund size.
Yes, I think there's two targets. One is the size of the fund, and that's critical so that we do attract further investment and grow the fund for the existing investors and for new investors, and also that we really achieve the dividend target that we set ourselves at the back end of last year at the IPO, which is a 4% net dividend this year for the existing investors. So yeah, we've got two things, and obviously we also alongside that is that with these investments is capital preservation. Mm. So yeah, there's a number of things we're looking at. Principally is getting to this magic £100 million mark. That'll keep existing investors very satisfied because they're part of a larger, more liquid structure. And also just ensuring that we maintain the dividend target that we set ourselves for the investment, for the investors at the back end of last year, which is 4% for the 2017 year, and then rising to 6.5% next year.
Some quite decent targets you set yourself. Are you pleased with how things are coming along?
I think we're delighted. You know, the investment team has done very well internally. So we've got a superb team at RM Capital. We're also growing that team. We're just recruiting a graduate to come on board. So the team itself is very pleased. We've recently moved offices again. So the resource base at RM Capital is growing in line with the fund expectations.
Very good. Look, I wish you all the best. James, good to see you.
Thank you, Andrew.
Thanks very much for coming in.
Lovely. Thanks a lot.